Okay, so we have the backing of NFHS that says, coach, that's a technical foul. As basketball officials, we need to have rules knowledge. We also need to know how to handle situations. When we have a disqualified player, sometimes it's strictly business. Sometimes the coach knows before you do. It's like, Billy, go get John, right? When they commit a foul, we go to the table, we report, and then they say, hey, ref, that's five. The coach already has the sub at the table. Sometimes it's strictly business as usual. Other times, we have to be prepared for a coach to potentially act out, and we need to manage those situations successfully. Billy Mack points out locally they have an opportunity. It's like that official can go opposite and another official can come over and say, hey, coach, that's five, and handle the disqualification process that way. But, you know, our entire process, you know, Al Batista has a great thing about the 50 things you can do to get better. And one of them is like throw 10 jump balls every day or read 5 case plays or what have you. But one thing you can really do, practice, is a disqualification procedure. As a young official, I've got a disqualified player. I've got a coach who thinks that was a really inappropriate call at that time. Marginal contact, incidental contact in their judgment, and you fouled out their best player, right? Something we can practice is, right, we have the foul, we go to the table, we report, the table says that's five, right? Maybe we're, you know, at a point where we know that's five before we even get to the table. We know we have put the fifth foul on that player, but we get that information. How we manage that process with a potentially upset coach is something that we can practice in advance so that when it happens in the game, it's not, surprising. Their behaviors may be surprising, but we want to know what we're going to say, how we're going to say it, how we're going to initiate the timer starting the 15-second interval, how we're going to respond when the interval ends, etc., and what we're going to do during that interval. We could practice that. We could practice scenarios, right? Scenario one, head coach says, I need my 20 seconds, or I'll need my 30 seconds. And then they bring their point guard over and they make a point of having a discussion. It's like, all right, so we're going to have to press now. We're going to do this thing. But they're really kind of acting out because they feel offended, right? What are we going to say during that interval that's going to lead to a situation of success, right? NFHS says, look, they are responsible. That head coach is responsible for getting that player to the table within the 15-second interval, and that's it. That is like a straightforward line in the sand. We're tired of coaches with this behavior. We need them to produce a substitute so the game can continue to move, okay? So we have the backing of NFHS that says, coach, that's a technical foul. Right? We've got to know what that's going to do to the game scenario as well. But we can think this through in advance. So we have a coach who, coach, that's five. I appreciate. I understand. I understand. You didn't like the call. I understand. I had illegal contact, but I need a substitute. Right? We can help them off the ledge. If they want to act out and have some sort of behavior, right? We can remind them, coach, I need that substitute now. You know, as the 15 seconds is going down, and then horn sounds, we can either assess, we can say, coach, no response, and then whack, whatever, however you want to manage the game situation. But it is something that we can practice, because when it happens in the game, that's a really critical moment for a young official, right? Or for an official in a hotly contested game, etc. Right? The easy stuff will take care of itself. But at that key moment, if we have a little bit of repetitions, then we can end up being stronger. So I strongly recommend for young officials is to take a moment and imagine that scenario and practice that scenario, right? If you're practicing your signals in a mirror, that's all fantastic. And that's really good. But we can also practice scenarios. And one of them is a disqualification, because they will happen in your game.